it's a large part of my music and music of a lot of my close associates. Involves finding different lines, different proportional lines between improvised and composed music. And everyone handles this in different ways, and I myself in different pieces and different periods of time will handle that differently. This project started actually in around 2008 when I was given the opportunity to do a set at the Stone in New York, and I thought about what band I'd really want to play with, and immediately Tim Berne and Craig Taborn and Gerald Cleaver came to mind for a quartet, and we had this one date with very little rehearsal. And immediately I felt like the music just had a life of its own. So many interesting things happened that I had decided pretty much at that moment that I wanted to record it. Members of this group, I have the longest standing history with Tim Berne. He, I think, first joined one of my groups, and then I did some of his projects, and we went back and forth like that for a while, and I always felt, from the moment we started playing together, I felt a real connection and an understanding about our approaches, rhythmic, melodic approaches, the way we thought about music. Craig Taborn, I guess I've only known for about 10 years, give or take, but I've always loved his playing. I just thought he's an amazing pianist, just with an amazing mind. Also, Craig is one of those musicians who there isn't anything I could possibly ask him about a music, about a band, about a recording, about whatever, that he doesn't have information on it. Gerald Cleaver and I probably go back around 10 years. Just an amazing wealth of knowledge about music. It's only really the last year or two that we've played together a lot. Now we seem to be in a lot of different situations together, and I'm just really just getting so much out of it. Playing right now in the background is 23 Neo. The idea was that I wanted to have different sections of music where some members of the group were playing a set thing, a repeating pattern, and the other members were improvising. And I had come up with this pattern. It happened to be a 23 beat pattern, so I used that title. The melody, which is fairly short, played by the saxophone and the bass, has a written part and an improvised part, and you can hear the written parts because they generally have some repetition to them. Probably more composed in the beginning and then becomes more improvised at the end. We thought The Rub and Spare Change was just a cool and really unusual title for the CD, and we really liked it.